What exactly is the state of the signatures collected with the People's Initiative?
Well, Ma'am Karen, as far as the signatures that were submitted to the Commission on Elections to all our local COMELEC officials from the cities and municipalities nationwide, all of these documents were in the possession of the COMELEC. We are safekeeping these documents. But however, there was one municipality already in the province of Antique that, we returned the document kasi po pumunta yung tao mismo. But likewise, we requested such person to give back to us the certification that we issued. Like what we are saying, anybody who submitted to the COMELEC these signature pages or signature sheets can get back these documents for their safekeeping. But however, if they wanted the COMELEC to safekeep these documents, we are very much willing. We will be accountable to these documents. But if they want, they can get these documents in the meantime.
Okay, I'm curious how many signatures have been submitted.
As far as the COMELEC monitoring is concerned, Ma'am Karen, 8,174,000 signatures were collected, representing more or less 120 legislative districts nationwide and more or less 1,100 municipalities and cities nationwide.
Okay, how many signatures are needed?
For purposes of the People's Initiative under the Constitution, you will be needing at least 12% of the 68 million. That would be about 8 million. So if you are going to get the percentage of the 8,174,000, that would be about 12.1% already, Ma'am Karen.
Okay. So technically, just for purposes of numbers, you have more than 8 million. Technically speaking, they just need 4 million more.
Technically, Ma'am Karen, it should only be about 8 million because the 12% of 68 million is more or less 8 million. But however, the Constitution likewise provides that aside from the 12% requirement for the entire country, the proponent must be able to get 3% per legislative district. And as I mentioned earlier, it would appear that there were only about 120 districts representing the 8,174,000 signatures. And therefore, they are still short of about 45 more or less districts because we have 253. So I would like to correct 210 legislative districts and we have 253 legislative districts nationwide.
Okay, but technically speaking, they already have the numbers. Kulang lang ng distrito.
Tama po, Ma'am Karen. Kulang lang ng distrito. Ano po yun, ma'am? The requirement should be a twin requirement, 12% nationwide and 3% per legislative district.
Okay, now the issue here is how will the COMELEC verify these signatures?
Well, as far as the COMELEC is concerned, we suspended indefinitely all proceedings, all processes pertaining to People's Initiative, meaning we suspended even the acceptance by our local COMELEC of the signature sheets. Simula po nung last week, we have not accepted anything from anybody. And we said that we are going to review first our COMELEC Resolution 10650. That supposedly is the IRR, the Implementing Rules and Regulation of Republic Act 6735. There were several legal issues such as, number one, is Republic Act 6735 really a valid law to implement the constitutional provision? Is it really the enabling law in accordance with our existing legal processes, number one. Number two, is COMELEC Resolution 10650 really sufficient or complete in order to prevent any irregularities or any problem during the verification part, for example, or during the submission? So that's actually the reason why the COMELEC suspended the implementation of our resolution. We wanted a complete overhaul review of this IRR.
Okay. Now, Senator Amy Marcos on Head Start is calling on the COMELEC to throw out all the submitted signatures. Sabi ni Senator Amy, baka magamit pa yan.
Actually, ma'am, we are fully understood the predicament of our Honorable Senator Amy Marcos. But however, ma'am, these documents were accountable documents already as far as the COMELEC is concerned. Sinabit po sa amin yan, we cannot just throw away these documents. And so these documents are in our possession. wala naman pong gamit pa yan. These are all mere scrap of papers. Not until somebody will file a formal petition before the COMELEC, a petition for a people's initiative attaching the certifications that each and every municipal and city election officers have issued, just to just an annex to the petition. Wala pa pong pinafile sa atin. In fact, if somebody will file, we will not even accept the filing of this petition in the first place. How can they file a formal petition with the COMELEC when they are really still short of 45 legislative districts, which we will not even accept these signature sheets?
I'm curious, I mean, just for discussion purposes, what is really the role of the COMELEC? Because ang mahirap dito, tinutuloy eh, ang people's initiative. It's still ongoing.
As far as signature gathering, Ma'am Karen, is concerned, we do not have a call. We do not have jurisdiction to stop the signature gathering. We do not even know what they are going to do with the signatures. But once they submit to the commission, our role in the meantime is ministerial because of our guidelines, COMELEC Resolution 10650, that we have to accept. Our election officers will have to accept the submission. But without touching these documents for purposes of verification. No verification yet. Mm. Only to accept
this
document.
That's not your role.
Later pa po yun, Ma'am Karen.
Oh,
later
pa po but yun. Whose role is that? Whose role technically is verification?
Yes, Ma'am Karen. After the submission of this individual, of these signature sheets before the COMELEC, our local COMELEC will just count the signatures without verifying whether these are really the signatures of voters or whether these are genuine signatures of voters. Wala pa pong ganon. We'll just count the signatures and we'll issue a one-page certification required by our IRR, which says that we received this number of signatures, this number of pages. We will give the certification to the proponent, and I think the proponent will be using that as an Annex B in their formal petition. That is the trigger where the COMELEC jurisdiction will start. We will determine when they file the formal petition with us whether their petition is sufficient in form and substance. In the event, Ma'am Karen, that we said, wala naman palang kwenta yung petition nila, kulang-kulang, when it comes to form or substance, we will immediately dismiss the petition. If the COMELEC will say, well, the petition is sufficient in form and substance, then local COMELEC, verify each and every signature in your possession. However, Ma'am Karen, I would like to stop short muna dun sa issue na yon. Ang problem po namin, when we reviewed our resolution, which was dated 2020, wala pa po ako dyan sa COMELEC at that time, madami pong kulang. For example, Ma'am Karen, if you're going to ask me, how will a signatory withdraw his signature from the signature sheet? Wala pong procedure doon sa COMELEC Resolution 10650. Number two, what if somebody would like to be an observer, a watcher during the signature verification? Ma'am Karen, wala rin pong nakalagay kung ano yung procedure. Number three, whatever is the decision of our local COMELEC, whether that's a signature of Karen Davila or not a signature of Karen Davila, what is the mode of appeal? How can somebody appeal the ruling of our local COMELEC? Wala rin pong nakalagay na gano'n. Napakadami pong wala ang kulang doon sa aming guidelines, and therefore it's really right on the part of the COMELEC to suspend the each and the proceedings as well as the implementation of that resolution so that we can review, we can overhaul, and we can add yung mga wala po doon sa resolution na yan.
I'm curious, Chairman, do you agree with the argument that the People's Initiative still needs an enabling law?
Yes, ma'am. Definitely, because
some say no more. Ang ibang kongresista, they keep saying no more. No need for an enabling law.
I think po, with all due respect, there should really be an enabling law because that's not self-executory. We need an enabling law because we need specifics on how the provision of the Constitution will have to be implemented. In fact, Ma'am Karen, hindi pa nga po sapat yung enabling law lang eh. That's the reason why the COMELEC had promulgated the IRR. You need specificity. Eh, hindi pa pwede yung law lang. Meron pa dapat more specificity, and that's why there is an IRR. So with all due respect, there is a need for an enabling law. And number two, there is really a need for an IRR to implement the law, implementing the constitutional provision.
Oh, so at the end of the day, all the signatures gathered, the People's Initiative, is it right to say it's useless because there's no enabling law?
That is now the debate, where the debate will come in, Ma'am Karen. I'm not yet prepared at this point to make a pronouncement as to whether Republic Act 6735 is a valid law or not. When I appeared before the Senate last week during the hearing by our Honorable Senator Amy Marcos. I made a pronouncement, my personal opinion only, but I did not say that that will have to carry the opinion of the entire commission, because we will have to come to that when the proper petition will come. In the meantime, anybody can question the whether really in the Supreme Court, whether really 6735 is a valid law, or anybody can question whether our IRR 1067650, which we suspended, is really a valid IRR.
And I'm curious, can you make an IRR without an enabling law? I mean, I know you suspended it already, but for purposes of discussion, could the COMELEC have done that?
No, ma'am. If there is no enabling law,
how could you have an IRR on what?
Yes, how can the spring rise above its source? And so you need a law before you will promulgate an IR. Maybe because, and that's maybe also the reason why the COMELEC made it a point to suspend our rules in the meantime, just to make a review and just to have a halt. And somebody will have to really go to the high court and say, and so that maclarify po talaga, is 6735 the enabling law that we are talking to in reference to people's initiative in accordance with our constitution?
Okay, but then I think you want to announce too that if you want to withdraw your signatures, you go to the local COMELEC office. Is that correct?
That's correct, Ma'am Karen. But surrender to us, give back to us the certifications that we issued, because we issued certifications saying that we received this number of sheets of papers containing this number of signatures. We need this certification. So, but in the meantime, if we will not be able to give back this certification, then we will not give back also the signature papers or signature sheets that you submitted to our local COMELEC.
All right. Okay, moving now. Let's talk about the elections. How are you preparing?
Ma'am Karen, take note, and this is for our televiewers, for the Filipino people to understand and to know that we will have two elections in 2025. The midterm election of May 2025, and 5 months after the barangay and SK elections of December 2020. Come to think of, these are two big elections. And so again, the COMELEC is hard pressed in our preparation. And that's why nung pumasok in People's Initiative, medyo nagulo kami, Ma'am Karen. Although it's our duty, we are prepared naman, but we are in the thick of our preparation. As correctly mentioned by Victoria Tulad earlier, we are now in the process of procuring not only the machines, because we set aside already the 97,000 old machines that COMELEC have presently, and we are now procuring the machines. List lang po, hindi po tayo purchase or bibili ng machines. Number two, we'll be procuring the transmission, and we'll also be procuring the, for the first time, Ma'am Karen, we're going to have internet voting for our overseas Filipinos. This is the first time in our electoral history.
And what software are you using?
Ma'am, the software and the hardware is actually bundled into whoever will be winning the procurement dun sa amin. So nakabundled.
I'm curious, have you, I know you were supposed to hold a second bidding. Tapos na ba yon?
Yes, ma'am. The first bidding was a failure because five bidders actually purchased our bid documents, but unfortunately only one participated, and that one was declared ineligible simply because there were two documents submitted which did not pass our eligibility requirement. Now we have now the second round of bidding, which started last January 8, and six bidders purchased our bid documents. 75,000, Ma'am Karen, isang bid document eh. And then during the submission, only one participated, and we wondered why. I am so disappointed. Bakit isa lang, samantalang anim yung bumili ng bid documents? We hope, of course, we do not have any control with that. And nung na-determine yung pong eligibility, that which is Miru, that company was declared to be eligible. However, we have not yet until today, until this very hour, awarded any contract to even to Miru, being the sole sole bidder, simply because ongoing pa po, Ma'am Karen, yung post-qualification na ginagawa. And if just in case they will not pass the post-qualification, we will declare them ineligible, and we will conduct the so-called negotiated procurement already.
But I'm curious, do you have new bidders?
We have several bidders as far as transmission is concerned. We will have the opening of the bids by February 8. And we have several bidders as far as our our internet voting is concerned. So napakadami naman pong bidders, ma'am. Kaya lang, sana po when it comes to the submission, all of these who purchased the bid documents will participate. Nakakalungkot po dahil we must have a lot of choices. Hindi po nakalimit lang kami sa isa o dalawa para po mas maganda na may choice ang COMELEC so that of course, depende rin po yan sa price na ipopropose po nila sa komisyon.
Oo, at may budget kayo, sir.
Yes, ma'am. And that's why I had said before publicly and during the hearing that 12 billion pesos that was given to us, supposedly according to them for People's Initiative, definitely that's not their call. It's ours. And we already had allocated that 12 billion pesos for the preparation for the 2025 national and local election and the barangay and SK election, the list of which we already submitted to the Senate.
Okay, all right, at least that's good to know. Now you are targeting also 3 million new voters.
That's right, Ma'am Karen, and the registration will start by February 12 up to September 30. And that's why before I was even telling everyone that if we are going to proceed with People's Initiative with the preparation for a plebiscite in the as an option as the end result of a People's Initiative, then perhaps we will be able to suspend the registration because we cannot do the same or two activities at the same time. But now we can now focus on our preparation for the registration, and we can focus on at least getting these 3 million prospective voters for the 2025 national and local elections.
Okay. Now I'm curious. The Senate right now is reviewing the economic amendments though for charter change. And Senator Sunny Angara said they may finish October, and that supposedly, if ever, make it in time for a plebiscite, right? I mean, take us through that process.
Ma'am Karen, under the Constitution, there are actually three modes of amending the same. Number one, either through a constitutional convention, elected members of the constitutional convention. Number two, through a constituent assembly by the Senate and the House of Representatives. And number three, by the People's Initiative. Again, yung huli po lahat lagi nito, yung tatlong modes na yan, is a plebiscite, a yes or no. Meaning the people will have to be consulted whether they will allow or not such a particular amendment. So if in case of the Constituent Assembly will be able to pass by this year or before the end of this year an amendment to a provision of the Constitution, unfortunately, and this is I would like to announce in your program, we cannot hold such plebiscite in 2025. The most that we can hold that is in 2026. Now, to those who will be saying, why not just
Tama na lang
simultaneously decision, I hope that we'll be able to review the decision of the Supreme Court in the case of Oxena versus COMELEC. The Supreme Court said in that case that you cannot include a plebiscite for the amendment of the Constitution and a regular election. Dapat ma, the people will have a clear mind because dapat po hindi halo-halo yung pagpipilian nila. Meron kang mag-e-elect ka ng leaders and then you're going to amend the Constitution. If it is amendment, focus on the amendment. If it is election, focus on the election. Simply because you are not amending just a simple law. You are amending the very Constitution, the very heart of our democratic processes. And so
okay, but even if it's economic provisions,
yes ma'am, whether economic or whatever provision, then this is an amendment of the Constitution and therefore it should be a separate single plebiscite so that the people can focus whether they will allow such an amendment or not.
Okay, but then the amendment to the Public Service Act, you remember this?
Yes, ma'am.
They did not go through this.
Yes, ma'am. It did not, because the amendment to the Public Service Act is actually a legislation and therefore it will have to undergo the usual process. But it did not amend the Constitution. It merely is an enhancement of the existing law on the public service, which is provided for by our Constitution. However, a direct amendment to the Constitution, like for example, you're going to add a phrase as may be provided for by law, then it will require a plebiscite.
Or for example, changing the ownership of land, that requires a plebiscite.
Yes, ma'am, definitely it will require, because the Constitution provides that land ownership in the Philippines should always be 100% Filipino.
But okay, if this administration wants a plebiscite in 2025,
I would like,
much do
I
they
would
need to give you?
yes, I would respectfully decline, because you cannot squeeze a plebiscite in the middle of an election. Even prior to May 2025, you cannot do that. In fact, Ma'am Karen, to be blunt about this, we cannot, we can, we our preparation is in the peak by October or even by November of this year. And surely by January of next year, we will be focusing on the May 2025 election. And if we, they will say, why not squeeze the plebiscite in the middle of the May and then December? We cannot do that. See, you need 1 year to prepare for an election. Try to imagine, Ma'am Kari, you only have 5 months to prepare for a barangay and SK election. Look at what happened in the October 2023 barangay and SK election. Mahaba na ngayong preparasyon. Madami pa rin po mga naging problema at kulang.
Wow, I mean, I'm curious, did anyone consult with you?
Nobody had told me, ma'am, but
this is the interesting part. You know, everybody's pushing, not everybody, but here they are pushing for changing the charter. You need a plebiscite. No one thought of consulting the COMELEC chairman.
Ma'am Karen, if
at the end of the day, it seems like a waste of time and energy.
If you're
the president could be like focusing on other things. You can't even do a plebiscite next year. What's the point?
If you're going to conduct a plebiscite, take note. Although it's a yes or no only, there's a lot of logistical problem, preparation. And number two, you are going to allow not only the Filipino voters in the country, but also likewise the Filipinos abroad. That's a national plebiscite. You have to consult also Filipinos who are not in the Philippines. So, ganun po kalawak. Yeah. Extensive yung preparasyon na gagawin namin sa isang plebiscite. Para din po siyang barangay and SK
election. Oo, ganung level. Anong yes, budget kailangan sa
13
plebiscite?
Billion, 13 billion pesos, Ma'am Karen.
13 billion?
For every plebiscite, you need 13 billion. So if you're going to change one provision and then you change another provision in the next plebiscite, you need 13 billion for each and every plebiscite.
All right. I think, Chairman, I think they needed to hear you. Okay? On that note, I want to thank you for joining me today, sir.
Thank you very much, Ma'am Karen. Mabuhay po. Salamat po.
Okay, take care.